2008, I lost a very dear friend in the Mumbai terror attacks. The attackers were found to be Pakistanis. Once the attacks happened, I was so angry and I was so hateful towards Pakistan. I'm an Indian. I was born and raised in Mumbai, and these attacks were very special for me. My mind was so full of anger that I started demonizing the entire country of Pakistan, and I started looking at Pakistani society as a society that supports terrorism. But a couple of weeks later, I started questioning my own anger. I started asking myself, why am I so angry at a country I know so little about? I don't have Pakistani friends. I don't read Pakistani newspapers. I don't watch Pakistani television. I don't know anything about Pakistan. It's not fair for me to pass judgments on something I know so little about. So I went on this quest to understand Pakistan, and I went on this quest to understand where does the terrorism in Pakistan stem from. And I started communicating with Pakistani journalists. I used to live in New Jersey at that time, so I started visiting Pakistani mosques and madrasas. I started hanging out in their neighborhoods. I made many Pakistani friends. This is one of the communications that I had with a Pakistani journalist called Mahir Ali, whom I asked, why is Pakistan a terror hub? And this is what he said. It's too simplistic to simply blame Pakistan. And Pakistan clearly is a victim too. Pakistani nationalism is the least of their motivations. Whatever interpretations of Islam they adhere to, it allows them to see plenty of Muslims as infidels. And they will have no qualms about killing them either. Over a period of time, I realized that Pakistan is a country that's at war within. There is a fringe minority of extremists who are trying to take over the vast majority of Pakistanis' way of life. And attacks, such as the Mumbai terror attacks, are happening almost on a monthly basis in Pakistan. Pakistanis are the biggest victims of terrorism. Once I had that realization, my anger turned into empathy. And I decided to make this documentary, which is now called Among the Believers. And the film talks about the ideological conflict in the Pakistani society, especially the ideological conflict from the point of view of education. So I went to Pakistan in October of 2009. My idea was to film with a few students from a madrasa and a few students from a regular school, and I wanted to see how their education shapes the way they look at the world. The day I landed in October, their own army headquarters was under attack. This is a photograph of the army headquarters attack. 10 Taliban gunmen had stormed into the Pakistani army headquarters, and they had begun firing. And about 9 soldiers were killed, and several others were injured. The day I landed, I saw a lot of chaos and a lot of confusion in the minds of people. Ordinary Pakistanis just didn't know what to do about this. They didn't know whom to go to ask for help. They didn't know whom to trust. And when I saw this mayhem, I completely realized what it means, what Mahir Ali meant when he said that Pakistan is a victim too. So then I soon began filming. I first went to a school, and I met this amazing girl called Zarina. Zarina had just escaped from a radical madrasa called the Red Mosque Madrasa. She had jumped over the wall, and she wanted to become a doctor. She had joined a regular school in her quest to becoming a doctor. This was one of the first interviews I conducted with her.
दीवार से छलांग गई और आगे बाकी कुछ भी नहीं डाला, वो तो पर्दा करते हैं ना, बुरका वगैरह कुछ नहीं डाला मैंने, ऐसे आ गई। मैंने कहा मैं छोटी हूँ, नहीं पता।
सो दिस इज ज़रीना। आई स्टार्टेड फिल्मिंग विथ हर एट हर स्कूल, एट हर होम, एंड over a period of time I also started digging into what kind of mosque did she escape from. She had escaped from the Red Mosque. Now you have to understand what the Red Mosque is. The Red Mosque was built by the government in 1961 as the Central Mosque of Islamabad. It was a mosque for the city's elites. In the 1979, the Soviet Union invaded Afghanistan. It was era of the Cold War. So America, along with Saudi Arabia and Pakistan, launched a jihad against the Soviet Union. The Red Mosque was run by Maulana Abdullah. He was the first cleric of the Red Mosque. He's a very fiery speaker. His job was to mobilize the masses to go and fight against the Soviet Union in Afghanistan. The mosque was partly funded by the American government and Saudi Arabia. And today, the Red Mosque is run by his son, Maulana Abdul Aziz. Maulana Abdul Aziz, like his father, is also a very fiery speaker, and he's one of the most radical clerics in Pakistan today. He's an official spokesperson for Taliban, and he has just pledged his allegiance to ISIS. So this is me with Zarina, and this is my co-producer, Naziha. So we began filming with Zarina, and we followed her in the school and in various places. When I was functioning in the normal Pakistani society, I effortlessly blended in. I could speak the language, I'm fluent in Urdu, and once I wear shalwar kameez, I almost look Pakistani. And I never felt like I was the outsider, I was the other. Once I and my co-producer Musharraf were at a lassi stall in Lahore, and we were talking about Bollywood films. And the stall owner picked up on my accent and he said, "Kya aap India se hai?" As in, "Are you from India?" And I said, "Yes." And then he said, "To fir to aap hamari mehman hai." So he said, "You are my guest." And he gave me a free lassi. And I have seen a lot of these things in Pakistan. Pakistanis opened their hearts and their homes to me. And I felt ashamed of my own intolerance towards Pakistan. But my fear did not go away. My fear actually got accentuated when I entered the madrasa. As an Indian Hindu, I knew that I would not be allowed in the madrasa. So I disguised myself as a Muslim woman. I said, "My name is Hena Khan, and I'm from Dubai." And they seem to like people from Dubai for some reason. So I disguised myself and I went in. Naziha and Musharraf told me, "Look, don't open your mouth. We do not want them to listen to your Bombaiya Urdu." And I kept quiet, and we filmed with various children at the mosque, and we filmed with this little boy, Talha, who is our second lead character. Talha is this 12-year-old, shy Kashmiri boy. When I first met him, he was so sweet that I really just wanted to hug him. We filmed with him. He opened up. He said he's at the mosque because he hopes to wear a special crown once he goes to heaven. I asked him, "What does he study?" He said that he memorizes Quran. I said, "Do you understand the meaning of the Quran?" And he said, "No, I don't understand the meaning of the Quran. They do not teach us the meaning of the Quran." And he said, "Mere memorizing is more than enough." But at the madrasa, you have to realize that I, Naziha, and Musharraf, all three of us were extremely scared. All three of us felt like we were in an alien place. I personally felt like this place, the madrasa, has no connection with the Pakistani society. You know, it was completely disconnected. Pakistani society is diverse, it's vibrant, it's imperfect, it's chaotic. It's like traffic in New Delhi. But the madrasa was not like that. The madrasa was regimented. Everybody followed the rules. There were rules, rules, and rules. And there was a promise of the heaven if you follow the rules. And that's about it. So the madrasa was the other. and not the Pakistanis themselves. And this is one of the clips from the madrasa.
Acha, aapko takreer aati tha? Takreer kahoge na? Takreer yaad hai?
Rozi.
Amma baad, fa'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم آج دیکھو شہدہ نے دا مسجد کے اوپر قربانی دیا ایک فرش میں جوتے جوتے کا اس نظامی جہاد کے اندر نہیں آ سکتا اب جہاد سے دا کے بھاگ سکتا ہے نہیں آ سکتا نہیں آ سکتا ابھی جا کے آ سکتا ہے تو گلا ڈرتا ہے اور کسی کو کہتا ہے آ جا جہاد کرنے
So that was Maulana Abdul Aziz with a little boy. This little boy is about 6 years old. You have to understand the Red Mosque. The Red Mosque has about 30 branches and it educates 10,000 students. It is spread out mostly in the northern part of Pakistan. So I made this little film with a girl and a boy, with Zarina and Talha, growing up in two different environments. But people said, you need more. And people said, you need to enter the Red Mosque. And I knew that as an Indian Hindu woman, if I tried to enter the Red Mosque, I would be killed. And I was also tipped off that I'm being watched. And I did not want to spend the rest of my life in a Pakistani prison. So I decided to collaborate with a Pakistani filmmaker, Muhammad Ali Naqvi. You see the one in the center, Muhammad Ali Naqvi. Muhammad Ali Naqvi then finally managed to get us into the Red Mosque. He's my co-producer on the right, Sayyid Musharraf Shah. So it took Sayyid Musharraf Shah about 8 months to get into the Red Mosque and to get into the inner circle of Maulana Abdul Aziz. And for the next 3 years, we filmed with Maulana Abdul Aziz. And you have to understand that these 3 years are one of the bloodiest years in Pakistani history. In these 3 years, the Pakistani society has had 2,000 terror attacks, over 1,000 schools destroyed, over 20,000 dead, and Osama bin Laden was caught. So it was one of the most dangerous periods in modern history of Pakistan. And these guys were filming at the Red Mosque. Obviously, there were threats. You know, there were these dangers of being caught, they were followed. We used to get anonymous phone calls, but we all survived that. And what happened in return is that I and Muhammad formed this special bond. You have to understand that Muhammad is a Shia Muslim. He's not a Sunni Muslim. Muhammad used to joke about it. Muhammad used to say, you know what, if Aziz finds out that a Shia Muslim and a Hindu Indian is making this film, he's probably going to kill me first. And that's the danger that was involved for Muhammad. But Muhammad took a leap of faith as well, because he wanted this story to be told. Because he has seen that how the forces of extremism have taken over his way of life for the past 20 years. And for him, this was his way of expression as well. So he took a leap of faith and collaborated with the other. And I collaborated with the other two. Zarina's school was shut down as a result of terrorism in Pakistan. She was eventually married off to a man twice her age. And she's 6 months pregnant in this photograph. This was the last time I saw her. Her school did not survive the rising extremism in the country. And that is what happens when society empowers extremist elements, is that it takes a toll on common people such as Zarina. The last shoot was about the Peshawar attacks. The Peshawar attacks were, you know, the 7 gunmen. This is an official photograph released by Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan for media to use. 7 gunmen had stormed into a Pakistani school, and they had killed 132 children just on point blank. These were the children who lost their lives. Our co-producer, Sayyid Musharraf Shah, lost 4 of his nephews in this attack. He's from Peshawar. After these attacks, Pakistani society decided to take on streets and fight head-on the rise of extremism within their own society. And the person who came in the center of this ire is Maulana Abdul Aziz. Because Maulana Abdul Aziz actually, after Peshawar attacks, said, condoned the attackers. He said, it's an eye for an eye. Thappad ka jawab to thappad se lagta hai. And a lot of people started demanding his arrest. I wanted my co-producer, Sayed Musharraf Shah, to conduct that final interview with Aziz. And I knew how difficult it would be for him. But Musharraf did. Well, at the end of it, we made this beautiful film called Among the Believers. It's screened in 21 film festivals, 11 countries, and it has won 6 awards. At the end, what I realized is that I realized the importance of tolerance. By being a tolerant person, you're not doing a favor on others. If we don't practice tolerance, eventually we will all end up killing each other and our societies will become unstable. And I've seen these patterns in many societies, and I see that in Indian society as well. And I'm fearful because this film, for me, is like a cautionary tale for societies that are grappling with intolerance. Empowering intolerant forces is like a recipe for civil war. Thank you so much.